Hello, dear friends. This is Dr. Zenkowski speaking from Mainz, West Germany. I shall try to accompany the videotape which has been produced by Rainer Holbe from Radio Tele Luxembourg, the radio broadcasting and television station from Western Europe, together with Klaus Schreiber, the man who lived in Aachen and meanwhile died the 7th of January 1988. Klaus Schreiber became famous during the last years because he succeeded by an optoelectronic feedback system to videotape single-frame pictures, improve them by sort of processing and getting images not only of the deceased persons of his own family, but at the same time from several famous people, actresses and other people which have been well known in Western Germany. I'll try to give always a short comment to the pictures. It is not very suitable to translate it in word by word, but I hope that it will give you at least a short impression how this videotape has been very carefully produced, and we feel that it is one of the best reports about Klaus Schreiber which has been so far radiated. Let's start with a look in Aachen, an old town in Western Germany, a nice town. And the message of Klaus Schreiber should make people glad. There is no death. There is only a change into another dimension of consciousness. Klaus Schreiber, on his daily visit on the churchyard, all his friends and his family are buried here. But he knows that it is only the flesh which is laying here, and that the soul and the spirit have changed. For him it is a place of meditation. Every morning he is coming here to get power and force for his work in transcommunication. The second wife died 1986. What has happened in the home of Klaus Schreiber is like a Greek tragedy. He had to bury most of his family, and it started with the death of his daughter Karin. She died with 17 years. This was her picture from Lifetime. She had to suffer a very long time, and she got an inflammation. And she had to go. She died one day before her 18th birthday. Since that time, my daughter Karin, you see, this is a paranormal picture. She is his contact person, and I am always in contact with her. It sounds like a fairy tale, but it is correct. She was the first to show herself on the videotape which I could produce. Karin shows herself moving. She is the most important contact person, and she makes short movements which are clearly discernible. She turns her head, she moves her hand, and she changes her face. She shows her teeth. She is laughing a little bit. She looks right and left. And all this is on my videotapes. Karin shows herself at an earlier age. Well, she shows herself in a very early stage of life in all forms. I have pictures in the age of 6, in the age of 10, and she shows herself up to the 16th or 17th year of age. They can do that from the other side. These are not direct pictures. These are electronically transposed ideas or thoughts. This is the first wife of Klaus Schreiber, Gertrud Schreiber. She died during birth of Karin. That means Karin never came to know her mother during lifetime, but they are showing themselves, both of them, together in one picture, united. Two faces on one body, so that means they are tightly connected. This is a paranormal picture of his first wife. They are able to show themselves into our world of thinking in pictures. In the third age of 30, she became younger and younger in the picture, down to 14 years of age as a girl. This is a father, the senior of Klaus Schreiber. He died in the age of 65 after a heavy life full of work. It took a long time till he showed himself. Like he was during his lifetime, he is answering from the other level of vibration. Here, this is a paranormal picture. I am thankful to Karin that she was able to bring him or to convince him that he should show himself. This is Robert Schreiber, the son of Mr. Schreiber. He is born 1946 and he died in the age of 22, 1968. He had some difficulties in his life. This is his paranormal picture. He seems to smile a little bit here. He was highly sensitive, and many things went to his heart. He was very happy at that time. He was the most sensitive of my children, and he answered immediately from the other side. And he told me why he left this world. He is well now. He is in the same range, on the same level of vibration like all the others of my family. This is Mother Katharina. She is tightly connected with my daughter, Karin. They show themselves together. And Karin is telling me my grandma is all the time together with me. So all of my family are tightly connected in their range. There's nobody of them who did not come through and did not give note of himself. This is a paranormal picture. She seems to sit. How can you explain? It is another world. Is it a world similar to ours? Only they are no longer bound to a body in our sense. The soul and the mind, the spirit, went over with all what they had in their memories here. And all this, what we have around us here, our nature and our world, it went with them together. This is the second wife of Klaus Schreiber, Agnes Schreiber. After my my first wife died, she took over the family, and she did all her duties all the long years, and she was happy to look forward to a nice and quiet life now. She did not help me directly in my work, but she did all the housework, and she took care of myself, and she accompanied me. This is a paranormal picture now of the second wife of Klaus Schreiber. It sounds unbelievable, like a fairy tale, but my wife is all the time around here. She had a very sudden death. And our friends from the other side, they are coming over to help me here. It is impossible for a human being on this world to understand how they are caring from the other side. I was unable to cook, and immediately after her death, I was able to do everything in the housework. I never did it before. So I understand that she was helping me, she was guiding or leading me from the other side. Like a professional, I was able to cook. Now there's a question, where is this other side? Can you tell us about that? Well, the other side, it is amongst ourselves. It has nothing to do with our time, which we are living in. They are all the time around us. It sounds like a riddle, but it is correct. Our partners from the other side, in their range of vibration, are all the time together with us here. Well, our body is laying here in the churchyard, but the pictures, the images show the people from the other side. How is this possible? Well, you see, this is the age of electronics. People now on our world are able to see that those from the other side, which we consider to be dead, are able to project their images, their pictures, and they are able to reconstruct their body to show them, to show it to us here. They can change their appearance, they can make themselves younger or older, and they must show themselves in such a way that we are able to recognize them. So again, these are electronically transposed thoughts or images. Now, this is a picture of Queen Mary, of the Mary, and it was a very surprising event. I was listening to a broadcast from the radio station Luxembourg, and I was listening, and during the same time I tried to get some pictures on my videotape, and I found afterwards in checking that tape that there was this picture. Normally I have my EVP system running parallel to the videotape, but in this special morning, it was a Saturday morning, I listened to this broadcast, and during your talk I had the appearance of Mary, it was like a flash on the screen, and it looks like a statue. Only a small part of a second I was able to recognize it, and I immediately switched on record, my videotape recorder, And she appeared at the same time during you were talking in the broadcasting transmission about Mary. This is a sign, a message to me from the other side, and it shows, it proves that from the other side they are able to follow what is happening here. Can you give me a message or a sign? And then she closed her eyes and she opened her eyes like a doll. All the other parts of the statue seemed absolutely still, without any movement. This is the original of an abbot from Austria. And this is a paranormal picture. This man died in 1955, and Klaus Schreiber received this picture without having ever seen this man personally, nor any picture of him in the literature. He gave his name to Klaus Schreiber, and this man, as an abbot, a Roman Catholic abbot, he was working on parapsychology and on the problems of life after death during his own lifetime. Klaus asked him, and he got the answer, well, this is going on, this is continued here on the other side. Now we have engineer Martin Wenzel. He had been asked how he could be able to explain what is going on, but it is impossible for me, he is saying. I only know from my experience and from my observations and from my tests that in this case there is nothing like a hoax or nothing like a trick, and Mr. Schreiber has no ideas and no purpose for tricking anything. He does all these things only out of the love to his deceased family. By EVP, they had told him to try the video system. It took him a long time, and after I came to know him, after he had recorded his first video pictures, and I helped him to improve the system, and I was a witness when he was working and receiving these pictures. And I have to say that there is no technical explanation whatsoever for this phenomenon. I am only sure that there is no technical trick. The phenomenon of video pictures cannot be explained on the basis of our today's physical experiences, maybe by theory, we are later on able to explain it. I should only like to mention the theory of Mr. Burkhard Heim from West Germany, who is working in a six-dimensional system and who has got some explanation for these physicalistic observations and events. I do not understand the theory because I'm not a theoretician, not a physicist, but I believe that this could be a guideline, and I feel that more physicists should consider these things, and they should say that our system, our world system, consisting of four dimensions, is not sufficient to explain these events. Now, this is a rather weak picture of one of our famous movie stars. His name is Kurt Jürgens. He is wearing the uniform of a general in a movie called The Devil's General. And now here you see a short cut of the forming of a picture. From this spot, from this bright spot, by several playing and replaying several times the original picture, we finally see the picture of our movie actress Romy Schneider. Here you have the clear picture after the processing. This is from Bavaria, the King Ludwig II. You have seen the first picture during his lifetime, and this is a paranormal as received by Mr. Schreiber. Now we'll have a short discussion with the physicist, which has written a book about energy. It is not so easy to explain what is happening in Klaus Schreiber's home. Images and tone, which is to be seen by us or to be heard by us, is coming from a world which we cannot see by physical means. And we cannot understand how this manifestation is realized. We can only suppose that the mind or the spirit has the potential from the infinite energy field and is able, through Klaus Schreiber's special faculties, to manifest the forms into the systems, into the technical systems. Klaus Schreiber himself might work like a transformer himself. He is changing the vibrations or the energy forms which we are unable to seize directly into forms which can be recorded or observed by our instruments. This way the information is coming onto the tape or onto the screen. Klaus Schreiber worked every day in his small lab. There is a description, a complete description of the system and the procedure he was using, because Klaus wanted that anybody who could try and who might have the same or similar special faculties, psychic faculties, let's say, should be able to repeat these tests or this procedure. There's always sort of mirror effect. Now what we are seeing here is again such a shortcut, such a compressed development of a picture. And when you are carefully looking, you probably might recognize the great Professor Albert Einstein. Look carefully. The picture will develop once more. Here it is. Professor Albert Einstein from the other side. Now we'll see the daughter of Klaus Schreiber. Her name is Elisabeth. How do you feel about seeing your mother on the television screen? To me, she is not dead. She is living. She is alive. She is all the time with us here. What shall I say anymore? She is not buried in the churchyard. I never thought about that. It is only the body which is laying there. She is not dead for me. This is a picture of a young lady which at the time of taping, of recording, was completely unknown. Again, another image and another one of people. And this, a young mother with a child. What is happening? What's going on when we are dying? Apparently, energy is leaving, vibrations are leaving our body. These vibrations go into another range, into an absolute energy field, which we aren't able to measure or to seize. Our mind, our personality is modulated on a special energy form which is leaving our body, and then it is in a timeless form. These are not vibrations or oscillations like we know them, our oscillations are in the time level. These other vibrations are in another level without our time. At any time, in any culture, the death was supposed as the peak, as the most important part of life. Only during the last 100 years, during the materialistic age, we started to be afraid of death. And now it seems that technical proof is necessary to convince people, and therefore these pictures and images should show us that the mind and the spirit will never die. This phenomenon of transcommunication by technical means is now realized in our world, and it is realized by thousands of people with more or less success, and we won't discuss the importance or the value of any special message, but the phenomenon that deceased people, not dead people, I shouldn't like to call them dead people, that these human beings, these spiritual beings, are able to contact us by means of voice or images. This must be thought, this must be worked through. It is not to be rejected, but it cannot be suppressed. All religions, all confessions are called upon working out and to think it out and to include it into their teachings. It is a fact, and it cannot be suppressed. Are these pictures the first technical proof for life after death? And are the churchyards only like junk places? Anyhow, what happens in the house, in the home of Mr. Schreiber, is an event which we should consider ourselves. And it is not only at Aachen that video picture has been received from the other side. In another place, in Luxembourg, people received pictures or images from an unknown dimension, and we have no idea from where they are coming. These people do not want to go to the public, to the open public. Maybe later on. So goodbye and good luck. This is the end of this comment. I hoped that it helped you to understand a little bit about the work of Klaus Schreiber from Aachen, West Germany. I might mention that Klaus, immediately after his passing over, came through in voice contact by different places, through different channels, radio channels, EVP, and that meanwhile we have a message from a lady from southern Germany, which clearly was able to observe him on her video screen, on her TV screen, after the normal transmissions had been shut down, and she did not know him at that time.